En toute fidélité, le régime républicain.
Breaking news: Gabon coup leader has sworn in as transitional head of state. This man promised to return powers to civilians, but specifically, he did not say when he is going to return powers back to civilians so that they can vote and choose a leader for Gabon. Now, a lot of people are saying, officials say the next country that coup will happen will be Nigeria. Please, I am not the one saying it. But come to think of it, if this coup happened in Nigeria, Africa will get the best freedom ever, because Nigeria, as the giant of Africa, if this thing happens in Nigeria and we get a good leader in Nigeria, Africa is going to be a better place. So currently, what is going on in Gabon now, the coup leader has sworn in as a transitional head of state, but he said he's going to return powers to civilians, but he did not say when he's going to return these powers to civilians. But we pray that they do so, so that they can vote, they can get a good leader to rule the country Gabon. After powers was seized from Ali Bongo, he was under house arrest. He was in his own residence. The wife was other side and the children were also in other side, and this man was appealing to the whole world that he was under house arrest. He don't know where his wife is, the children. Let's watch that video. When we are back, we'll give you the rest of the update. So stay tuned.
I'm Ali Bongo Ondimba, president of Gabon, and I'm to send a message to all the friends that we have all over the world to tell them to make noise, to make noise. For the people here have arrested me and my family. My son is somewhere, my wife is in another place, and I'm at the residence. Right now, I'm in the residence and nothing happening. Nothing is happening. I don't know what's going on. So I'm calling you to make noise, to make noise, to make noise, really. I'm thanking you. Thank you.
I hope you have seen the video. That was the video Ali Bongo did after they seized power from him. Now let's watch the swearing in video where the coup leader has become the transitional head of state of Gabon. When we are back, we will give you the rest of the update. So stay tuned.
It's our correspondent Catherine Norris Trent sent this update from Libreville. General Brice Oligui Nguema, in his speech at his inauguration ceremony, promised to return power to civilian hands and to hold credible, free and transparent elections. But he didn't say when that would be. He also said he'd be holding consultations on drawing up a new constitution for Gabon and putting that to a referendum. And he also talked about perhaps overhauling Gabon's electoral system. So, you know, that sounds like a great deal of work, which could take quite a long time. So there's no date for this transition over which he's presiding to end. But from his pronouncements yesterday, it doesn't seem like it would be a rapid affair. He did say that he would be forming a government within the coming days. We didn't get much more detail than that, apart from that he said he would be involving experienced people. He and other members of the military, which seized power toppling Ali Bongo last week, have been holding consultations with civil society, with business leaders, some members of the opposition. So they say that they're trying to include a larger number of Gabonese people as possible. But at the moment, there are no concrete guarantees on just when the return to civilian rule might be.
Of power, of dignity, of freedom for Africa! Africa for Africans! The land of Africa is for Africans everywhere! Our land is our land! Everything is our land! My brothers, everywhere! You are the master of your continent! You are free in your continent! In this hostile campaign, you are strong now! You are marching to the glory, for once, to the progress!
Yeah, guys, I hope you have seen the video. So currently, they have sworn in the coup leader as the transitional head of state. So with time, he is going to return powers back to civilians. But he did not state when he is going to return the powers back to civilians. And this is that I have for you today. Let me know the next country you wish this coup will happen? Let me know in the comment section below. But guys, I am not saying it will happen in Nigeria. You guys want to put me in problem. But if it happens, as I said before, it is going to be the freedom Africa has ever had, because you know, Nigeria being the giant of Africa, it is going to be a big progress. Until we meet again in the next video, please stay safe and stay blessed. Peace out. If you are from Nigeria and you have not yet downloaded TapTapSend, guys, you are missing. TapTapSend is a simple app that allows you to send money back to Nigeria. You can send money through bank accounts and even cash pickup. You can download TapTapSend on Google Play or App Store. Guys, download the application and register. In your first transfer, if you use my promo code OfficialNiger, you are going to be getting additional 5 euros, $10, depending on where you are living. And this app is very, very easy and simple. A lot of Nigerians are using this application to wire money back to Nigeria, because this app, their rates are very, very higher. I'll be leaving the link in the YouTube video description. Just click on the link, download the application, use my promo code to send money back to Nigeria and get additional 5 euros. And don't forget, the promo code is OfficialNiger, OfficialNiger. Please don't forget to share this video for me.